to another edition of Women Lead TV. I'm Michelle Bergquist, your host, and with me today, we're smiling. I'd like to introduce you to Jodie Grenier, who's the Executive Director of the Foundation for Women Warriors. And please just stop for a moment. Yes, Foundation for Women Warriors. This is an amazing organization, and I want you to say hello
to everyone.
All of our attendees. You are the executive director. I want to hear just a brief overview because this is, to me, an incredible organization that specifically focuses on women veterans. So tell us a little bit about what the foundation does.
So women have served our country for well over 100 years. We're coming up on the 100-year anniversary of women being able to enlist in the Marine Corps.
Wow.
On the heels of the first woman passing the infantry officer course and becoming the first infantry officer yesterday. So what the organization does is we honor the service of women veterans by empowering their future. Mm-hmm. We do that in a number of ways. We meet their basic needs, whether it's housing, emergency financial support, or child care assistance. And then of course we have a robust resource and referral program that allows our women to either be mentored or seek resources outside of what we provide.
How did you, first of all, tell everyone you are a veteran.
I
always want to ask you, it's like, do we say thank you for your service? I mean, so many people are heart-centered about that, but
right.
I'm always curious, is that a good thing to do as a veteran? Do you want to hear that?
I think that it depends on the veteran. I think that some appreciate it because it bridges that immediate, oh, you served, but I didn't, and I want to show you that I'm appreciative of your service. It's a way to identify as I'm a patriot too. I think that it varies, but it's safe to say thank you.
I think it's always, I know I want to come back to just what I was asking you before, but I think so many of us as, let's just say women in business or even just general, in the United States, we kind of go, what do we say to a veteran? We're so appreciative of all that you and others do. And I think we're kind of like, we feel a little clunky and funky about it, but we want to be able to show appreciation or say thank you. It's a tough thing,
It can be. And I think
you're humble about it, and yet we want to go, you are all that.
I think that it can be considerably awkward in some circumstances, but I find myself as a veteran when I encounter other veterans, it means you served in the past. Mm-hmm. So I try to focus on, well, what are you doing now? Mm-hmm. What's next? And what are the ways that I can help you? And I think women in business or anyone in business, that's a way to really leverage a relationship is what are you doing now and finding ways to assist in empowering or advancing maybe a veteran's career.
And that's what I love so much about what you do is that the transition is pretty tough and rough for women to get out of the military.
Right.
And then what's the next step? Right?
Right.
I mean, I always equate it, when you're in college, you start to build a network of people you know,
yes.
Right? Then you start working your career and you build even more people that are part of your network. When you leave the military, there's no network.
Right.
It's like there's no safety net. So how do
right.
you bridge that piece for women veterans?
So I think it's different based on your point of entry into the mm-hmm. military. So if you are an officer, typically you've gone to college, you have gone to college prior to serving. But if you're enlisted, you go in right after high school, or maybe you tried college and it didn't really work out. So we serve majority of enlisted women that have exited service. And when you get out, you leave your network in the military. And so it can be daunting and overwhelming. And your mentors are also still either in the military or navigating civilian life blindly by themselves. So it is overwhelming. And then there's other considerations too, where women aren't initially observed or understood as being veterans.
Well, and talk a little bit, again, not a lot of detail, but for you, the transition of your expertise in the military,
right.
and how that doesn't always equal what
right.
corporate America finds that fits. I mean, you're almost overqualified when you
right.
leave the military of what you were working with, as far as what I understand, and
right.
some of your stories that you've shared.
Especially, I think, the enlisted folks that get out, they don't have a college degree, and that's typically your your point of entry into any career is I have a bachelor's degree, mm-hmm. and then you build your skill set in corporate America. You start with that that college degree, so that becomes an obstacle or a barrier of entry for our veterans. Though they have skill sets, much like nurses and different medical personnel, they have to go to school all over again, which is frustrating.
Talk about some of the services the foundation does. I mean, and the bigger picture is what attracted you to work with the Foundation for Women Warriors?
So my own struggle getting out of the military, I went back home to a small town, and I found myself very frustrated working as a bartender and waitress and going to a community college, knowing that, you know, my job was to mitigate the threat to our troops and task out unmanned aerial planes and assess battlefields and report to commanders.
Can't even get my arms around what that was, right? And then you're like bartending.
Tending, which is... And you're like, oh, whoa, so I guess that'll be 5 Jaeger bombs instead of actual bombs. It was humbling and frustrating, but I then continued my career in the intelligence field. I was fortunate that the skill set I did have in the military still applied to government positions. And then through that, I really found my altruism at the forefront working with veterans. I think a lot of what we do personally is try to assist people in struggles we've had ourselves. So it just seemed like a natural fit that I would, you know, run an organization.
You're doing some big things with the foundation. I love what I've seen you do, and I've heard some of your passion for the future and what you're trying to do. I've also heard you speak, and you talk about some of the things that women in the military right now should be looking at as they think of transitioning.
Right.
Can you share maybe a few tips if we are reaching, and we hope we are, other female veterans or those looking to opt out? What would be some
Absolutely.
Tips you'd suggest?
Think and dream big.
I like that. Go with that.
Please, think and dream big. Nothing is off limits to you. Mm-hmm. Ivy League schools, apply to them. Don't limit yourself to what you believe is accessible. Find someone that you think has an amazing career, or really dig deep and think about what you're passionate about, mm-hmm. and the money will follow. Don't limit yourself. Find people outside of your way of thinking and enlist them as your own personal board members. And start planning. Start planning financially, and start planning for your education. And I promise you, you'll be successful.
I like that. Can I add one?
Yes.
Is that okay? I also think it's like, when you're in the military, start to reach out to the business community of where you're at and where you're thinking of moving.
Exactly.
And start to integrate within the business community, because trust me, I do feel there's a lot of business leaders that want to help, that want to support, want to connect you. You know, if you're not utilizing that network, that maybe you don't have that reach to, start with one person, and it'll build like a wildfire.
Ask for help.
Yeah, we don't do that as women as much, do we?
No, we don't. Ask for help, and like you said, build your network. The network, you get more jobs from the people that know you and trust you than you will from just applying.
Well, and we're excited to partner with the Foundation for Women Warriors and Connected Women of Influence.
Right.
So kind of share maybe a couple of the big vision type things that you have that you're thinking of with the Foundation for Women Warriors. I know you've redone a new website. You've done the Connect to Community event, which we are so excited to be a part of and do it in a bigger way.
Right.
There's some other things that you're looking to do in the near future that people might be excited about?
Yeah, absolutely. So some of the things that we plan on doing is we had Connect with Community at University of San Diego with the San Diego Veterans Coalition's Women's Networking
group. That is a mouthful. I don't know how you do that.
And that pilot was very successful. We brought in women from Connected Women of Influence and different business leaders within San Diego, and afforded the opportunity to our veterans in transitioning active duty to do just what you said, build their network, connect with women outside of the military, and start to plan their futures. So we want to repeat that in Orange County and LA in 2018.
I love it. Any final words that you want to share with our listening audience?
You're all awesome. Dream big, and the only limits you have are the ones you place on yourself.
And that's a wrap for another Women Lead TV series. We'll be back again. Thanks, Jodie, for being our guest.
Thanks, Michelle.